Determine the area enclosed by three straight lines y is equal to 4 minus x, y is equal to 3x, and 3y is equal to x. The question it is not difficult for us, so let us see how it is being worked out, the solution. So let us just start by sketching, because sketching will make our working easier. Let us try to sketch. Of course, we know that this is the y-axis. This is the x-axis. So can we be able to say that for the first line, which is y is equal to 3, that is 4 minus x. So this means our line will start from a point 4 here, and then it's having a negative gradient, so it will just come down like this. This is y is equal to 4 minus x. The other line is y is equal to 3x. Remember, when it is y is equal to x, it is a straight line through the origin. So this one will just move a little bit up, and then it becomes this is y is equal to 3x. And then the last line, that is 3y is equal to x, is like y is equal to x out of 3. So that line will just cut here like this way. That is 3y is equal to x. And then the required area is just this one. So what we have to do here, we have to find this point of intersection here, and then we also find the point of intersection here. Now we determine it by integration. In fact, the question is saying determine the area enclosed by three straight lines. This one by integration. Yes. So now what we have to do, for us to find the point here, we have to equate to this point of intersection. We equate just the two lines meeting, that is 3x is equal to 4 minus x, and then it means 4x is equal to 4, then x is equal to 1. So this is our point 1. Let us do the same for the point of intersection of the line, this one and this one. So what we have to do here, let us just equal them. So we say x out of 3 is equal to 4 minus x. So x out of 3 plus x is equal to 4. Then it will just give us x is equal to 3. So this is a point 3. So then let us determine that area by integration. So please begin here. This is where we have complications. So, but it is very simple. It's not difficult for us. This is a point 0. So we are integrating from 0. We find these areas separately. Integrating from 0 to 1, we find this area up to this point, up to this down using this equation. So that is from 0 to 1 using the line 3x. And then, of course, having found that one, we have obtained even the unshaded area down here, this one. So we have to subtract it, and therefore we say minus the integral from 0 to 1 using this equation now, x out of 3. Yes, having done to that point, then now we add, we are supposed to add the other area, because this area actually we have not added it, so we just add. So it means we find this area using equation that is the integral from 0 to 1, from, in fact, not 0 to 1 but 1 to 3 using the equation 4 minus x. Then finding that one, you've obtained the area that we don't want. We find this one, of course, we want this one now, but there's an area we have included here which is not required, this one. So if what we have to do is to subtract that area. So minus the integral from 1 to 3, then now we subtract using x out of 3. Then of course dx. So having done this, then the equation is almost over. So what we have to do is just for us to integrate. So integrating that, and therefore we'll be able to obtain that it is remember this one, it can be written as integral from 0 to 1 3x minus x out of 3, because the limits are the same, then plus the integral from 1 to 3 4 minus x, then minus x out of 3. Then let us integrate that, then we insert our limits, and then we do away with this question. So it is giving us, integrating that, we can be able to find that it is 3 out of 2x squared minus x squared out of 6. Then the limit was from 0 to 1. Then, of course, plus the other area, which is 4x minus x squared out of 2 minus x squared out of 6. Then the limit was from 1 to 3. So then what we have to do is just to insert our limits. We have 0 will not affect, and therefore what 1 will affect, therefore we remain with 3 out of 2 minus 1 out of 6 for the first case. Then minus, it is plus 1 times 3, 4 times 3 is 12, minus 3 squared is 9 out of 2, minus 3 squared is also 9 out of 6. This one, minus, the limit is 1 now, so it will be 4 minus half, and then minus 1 out of 6. So let us work out this one now. We can be able to obtain our answer as 4 square units.